Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. It has been, I think, 2 days. Today I had a midterm, so I had I couldn't post yesterday and today for a couple of hours, for I needed to rest. Excuse me. And thus here I am. I actually prepared and published a video about how the channel will change, what is my next schedule, and when will I produce which content. It is on the channel as Dorukhan Özen channel update. You may want to check it out if you have time, for it's nearly half an hour. Today, Tuesday, is now official Tribal Tuesday, where we make tribal videos, and in order to progress I had to finish the last two videos that I promised that I would make. In those, in order to meet Hex Reborn subscribers suggestion, as we are going Space Marines, thanks to him, I want to make a tribal Death Watch, as I have seen Artemis from the Death Watch. Regardless, as I have seen, there are only 3 Space Marines: Jetek, Suberai, the Death Watch Biker, Brother Gion, Death Watch Black Shield, and finally Death Watch Vanguard veteran Edric Setorax. Only 4 Death Watch Space Marines are available, which is quite a shame. Let me quickly upgrade 2 levels of Brother Gion. Now his trait is unlocked. Quite lovely to now upgrade the first upgrade to unlock traits. So what I wanted to make after this, I wanted to include some of the Space Marines that weren't really being played, at least by me. So I have actually included 2 of the Iron Hands Space Marine chapter: Iron Chaplain Furnos, Iron Hands Chaplain. Let me quickly upgrade him. He is also a melee focus. Now his regeneration is unlocked, and he has a decent melee attack for his cost. And Malkan Pharos, Iron Hand Master of the Forge. Once again, another regeneration unit with a decent health pool. Now let's upgrade him to level 3 to upgrade his ranged attack. Quite a lovely Space Marine in my opinion, quite tanky. And one Brother Anuri from Raven Guard, Vanguard veteran. And finally, Kasor the Damned, Blood Angels, Dead Company Dreadnought, as Hexreborn suggestion. I hope to make this card work this time. I hope I can manage to do that. We are running one Space Marine short, so we will trigger one less of the Artemis' special rule of 20% total HP. Regardless, in order to make a team, and as you can see, there is a dark team apparent in this deck, and I will simply conclude this deck as the Watch Captain Artemis' tribal Death Watch Black Lives Matter. So let's go and find whether political sensitivity of the current era will protect Artemis from being cancelled in the ranked ladder. As the first episode of today's Tribal Tuesday, there will be another video to be published before around 15 minutes later the stream will start on the Twitch, so you might want to check that out as well. We have the initiative, so let's just go ahead and take down their psykers. I don't know if they have multiple psykers in their deck, but most likely they have. So let's go ahead and focus on them. Yeah, we will go ahead and upgrade our scout and buff our melee. Lovely 57 attack over there. It will take a long time for old one eye to heal. Probably has 8 HP to heal, right? Yeah, 16. Will take 3 turns to completely heal. Regardless, let's see. Probably in 2 attacks we will take down. Thanks to the target equa... No. Just not good enough. Ah, that's so sad. Okay, okay, we have taken one of their psychers. Yeah, the actual unit that we need to take down is here. Actually, this is quite similar to what I run in my Tyranid Swarm Lords deck. I also run Malasaptor, Cult Magos, the previous Psyker unit, and also the bigger one with the melee attack variant. We can go melee. We have around 19 additional attack. You are not needed. Hive Tyrant. We can go ranged. Ranged is also unchallenged, so let's go ranged. Unfortunately, currently our team is a little bit underleveled. Game matchmaking might have been triggered a little bit. Ha, what can we do? We can just simply deploy Kasor on the middle and take down the Magos at the first round. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Regardless, they will most likely to go ranged. Sorry, psychic. I'm quite tired today. For the last 2 days, I have slept only 8 hours in total for 2 days. The midterm has really taken my energy. Okay, perhaps we can actually transition Kasor on the left to actually perhaps we can do something else. Let's go ahead and do it as such. Black Shield on the center. Okay, passive hit the old one eye over there. Perhaps I should have, yeah, I should have selected the higher. Yeah, stream reminder has gone off. Alright. Regardless, in the next round we are going to take them down. We have been wounded a little bit. Regardless, the one Gene Stealer and one Leviathan Fleet Tyranid unit will fall down. And after that, Warlord's left flank will be open. And thus we can use double attacks on his side. Also, the Psionic Blast will be over. So our regen unit, Iron Hands Space Marine on the right, will be safe for now. It's alright, Kasor can still take in 2 more attacks. Also, let's see, 40% of the total attack, around 13-ish, that's not good enough. So, let's go ahead. Wonderful, 33% of a chance to take down Monoceptor, we did it, alright. Let's go pick melee, we have 167. Actually, the Black Lives Matter hashtag actually worked for the deck. I wasn't really hopeful. It was just a meme, but memes work. Memes work. Memes actually work. It's the scientific proof of it. Okay. High Tyrant is on here. They put fear on us. Selected Psychic, for they are actually afraid of our 52 ranged attack. And as you can see, we can unleash 156 melee. We can unleash 107 ranged, but with a 54 opposition. So, let's go ahead and do the melee attack with 120 net difference in our advantage. Unfortunately, Raven Guard, right? Yes, Brother Anuri falls. Yes, Kasor has received 15 damage. Regardless, I think this time Kasor will receive see the end of this battle. If at the end of the turn High Lord doesn't hit him. So what I actually like, with a 66% of chance Kasor doesn't receive damage from High Lord. Why he has to fall? It was going to be an achievement, but it's gone now, it's alright. He did his best. Even as a Dreadnought, it was his second life, but he served the Empire. He fought valiantly. This episode was lovely. Okay, we have received 51 trophies, 4 skulls. Let's see what kind of chest did we get. 12 or 18 hours, something. I don't like 12 hours, 8 hours, 18 hours and 24 hours chest. What I like is 3 hours chests. I can actually open 6 or 7 of them in a day without any complaint. For in my experience, the reward percentage drops are wonderful for 3-hour chests, because you open so much of them, you trigger those small chances far more than the 12, 18, 24 hours. I got so much legendaries out of 3-hour packs, while the 8 hours resulted in mostly rares and epics. I got even more epics in 3 hours, for I could open 3 hours in a 9-hour span instead of a 8-hour chest. And that's another thought of mine. Thank you for joining me in this Artemis Space Marine Tribal episode in a Black Lives Matter version. I hope in the future we receive enough Deathwatch members, which I highly doubt, for as you can see there is like we still need 3 at least Space Marines and 1 Dreadnought in order to fill a complete deck, even though I like 10 points still. So it's a really long shot. Regardless, you have seen the deck and it's actually functional and it's actually fun to play. Thank you for joining me tonight. Have a nice day and night, and see you later in the next episode of Tribal Tuesday, where we feature Logan Grimnar's Space Wolves. Take care.